Annappa A. Valikar, works in the Department of Computer Science Engineering, Valchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So today I am going to deliver a lecture on current state of IoT in India. As part of learning outcome, at the end of this session, students will able to familiarize with the current state of IoT in India. But before discussing a current state of market of IoT in India, technology beyond the IoT and customer expectation from the current IoT, we will discuss some introductory part of IoT. IoT can be divided into three categories based on usage and client base, such as consumer IoT, commercial IoT, and industrial IoT. Consumer IoT includes the connected devices such as smart cars, phones, watches, laptops, connected appliances, and entertainment systems. Commercial IoT includes things like inventory controls, device trackers, and connected medical devices. Industrial IoT covers such as things connected electric meters, wastewater systems, flow gauges, pipeline monitors, manufacturing robots, and other type of connected industrial devices and systems. We'll begin with IoT journey in India. India's IoT journey is only about 5 to 7 years old, but has been suffering from being stuck in a long sales cycles and generating little revenue. PricewaterhouseCoopers report says that IoT market in India is projected to grow at a compound annual growth rate more than 28% annually by end of 2020. IoT 1.0 may have just ended, and startup may have to gear up for IoT 2.0. So we'll discuss a current IoT market in India. According to PricewaterhouseCoopers, IoT is only a $130 million market in India today, and the government's objective is to develop the industry to the tune of $15 billion by 2020. All registered companies have raised money, out of which 28 of having raised $67.68 million in venture capital funding. According to NASSCOM, the IoT market in India is expected to reach $15 billion by end of 2020. IoT market expanded across all the corner of the business, including from wearables, connected houses, IoT infrastructures and sensors, healthcare and service, energy, utilities, and etc. And this picture depicts that the different companies invested in the IoT infrastructure to run their day-to-day business. We'll discuss about statistics of IoT in India. According to PwC, out of 40 registered Indian IoT companies, 3 had annual revenue in excess of approximately 5 crore rupees. India's Department of Electronics and Information Technology states that the India captures a 5 to 6% share of potential $15 billion global bonanza by end of 2020. We'll move to people expectations from IoT. Tata Consultancy conducted one survey among different sections of people in India, and different people express different view on the survey. We'll discuss this statistics of survey. 13.3% of Indians expect IoT to deliver improved levels of healthcare. Around 20.5% of respondents anticipates better traffic management. 24.7% expect a reduction in air pollution. 14.5% of Indians see an immediate association of IoT in the delivery of improved public services leading to a better quality of life. This diagram indicates a different industry install units at a different year. In 2016, total 6,381 units were installed by different companies, and that number increased to 8,380.6 in the year of 2017, and in 2018 it will be 11,196.6 and 20,415 going to be installed in the year of 2020. So this statistics show that due to the expectation from a people and the need of IoT, and all industry come together and start investing in the IoT units. So now we'll discuss what pushes the growth of IoT in India, and these are the some of the points that give input to the how, why growth of IoT in India happens. Increased availability of affordable smartphones, hyper growth in the developers or startup ecosystem, focus of semiconductor companies on IoT by providing products for various use cases, increased corporate and government investment in IoT and related opportunities such as smart cities and digital India. And allied factors like cloud services, big data analytics also pushes the growth of IoT in India, and growth of APIs also makes a growth of IoT in India at a large extent. Now we'll move to the how people are expecting from IoT, and 9.6% of people expect IoT to be better access to public services. 20.5% of people want IoT to reduce traffic congestion and queues. 24.7% people expect from IoT to lower levels of pollution and environmental impact, and 31.3% people say that IoT is required for the better personal health care, and 13.8% of people want IoT to be improved safety or security for a citizen. So this indicates that the larger section of the people expect more from IoT for their day-to-day life. And also people accepted the this new technology from their home to office. 10.0% people said never use IoT in their house for their day-to-day life. 35.2% people definitely says yes, I am going to use IoT technology in their day-to-day life. 40.1% people say probably I am going to use IoT technology in the house for their day-to-day life, and 14.7% people say that unlikely I am going to use IoT technology in their life. So this picture indicates how the people using the fridge that is enabled with IoT technology. So I have one question for you people. Just pause the video and answer to the question. What are the technologies beyond IoT? Okay, these are the technologies beyond IoT: RFID, that is radio frequency identification, and refers to technology whereby digital data encoded in RFID tags or small labels are captured by a reader via radio waves. ZigBee is an IEEE 802.15.4 base specification used to create personal area networks with small, low power digital radios, such as for home automation, medical device data collection, and other low power, low bandwidth needs designed for a small scale projects. Wi-Fi is a wireless networking technology that allows computers and other devices to communicate over a wireless signal. Bluetooth is a wireless technology standard for exchanging data between fixed and mobile devices over a short distance using short wavelength. So these are the number of devices connecting to the different applications. The 34.6% of the devices are smartphones, 14.5% are used in the public services, 14.1% devices are used in the smart homes, 11.4% devices are used in the smart cities, 14.2% devices are used to connect to the other devices and working with each other for the common good, and 11.2% of devices are used in the social media. So these are the references I have cited to prepare the this PPT, and two are books and two are the internet search. Thank you.